अस्सलाम वालेकुम, वेलकम नाइन्थ क्लास टू टी। आई विल डिलीवर लेक्चर नंबर 7 ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 1। एंड इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर आई वाज डिस्कस एक्टिविटीज 1.1 to 1.8। एंड टुडे आई विल डिस्कस रिमेनिंग एक्टिविटी 1.9 to एंड। सो स्टूडेंट, फर्स्ट यू हैव टू ओपन योर नोटबुक एंड आल्सो फर्स्ट यू हैव टू ओपन योर टेक्स्ट बुक एंड यू हैव टू गो ऑन योर टेक्स्ट बुक and find out the section 1.34. so there is a one algorithm you have to check, algorithm number 9. okay, so first you have to write the algorithm 9 and you will compare the algorithm 1 with algorithm 9. okay, that which algorithm is too much efficient. Now I will take start. First, basically what is algorithm? That you have to enter two numbers, number 1 and number 2. Number 1, this is the starting point, and number 2, this is the ending point. 1 to n2, you have to find out the numbers which are even. So what you will do first, obviously we will take out start and we will enter input number n1 and n2. n1 means starting point, maybe it will be start from 1, and number 2, this is the 5. Okay, n2 presenting 5, this is the last number. So I have assigned 1 to n1 and I have assigned 2 number 2 to 5. Okay, it means n2 is equal to 5. So you will find out the even number from 1 to 5. And other thing, that which steps are involved, you will check all these things. First of all, first step is a start, of course. Second, input number 1 and 5. Okay, n1 presenting 1 and n2, this is the last. It's mean that 1 to 5. And next, of course, you will check that if number 1 is odd and set number 1 to n1 plus 1. Okay, n1, this is the first number, and plus 1, it's mean 1 plus 1 starting number is 1. So here the statement is that if number 1 is odd, then you will add the number 1. It's mean that number 1, this is the first, and starting number 1 plus 1, this is, it will be 2, and output n2 n1. okay, so n1, it's mean now you got the 2 marks, 2 number, this is even number. After this, what you will do, set n1 to n1 plus 2. n1, this is the 2 number now, because output is 2 plus 2, this will be 4. So what you will do here, the condition is if n1 is less than n2, go to step 4. It's mean if n1 is less than n2, it should be go to step 4 on output. So first you have to count all these steps. We have done 6 steps. Okay, so now we will go back step 4. That is step 4, output n1. It's mean that now output is 4, because n1 is 2 and plus 2 is equal to 4, and output will be 4. So we have done output all these numbers which are given, which are required, 1 to 5. So what we will do, we will check once again that, and now move on third step. n1, it's mean this is 4 plus 1. Okay, then we will go on step 5. n1 is 4 plus 2, it will be 6. So now we will move on 6. We will check n1 is less than n2. It's mean that 6 is less than 5. n2 is presenting 5 ending number. Go to step 4. It's mean that it have to go on step 4, output, it will be invalid because this is not present. It's mean we have done 10 steps. Okay, if we want to show 1 to 5 numbers, then we will complete our work in 10 steps. Okay, algorithm take only 10 steps and take only 10 steps for output. Now we will check the algorithm 9. First you will find out the section 1.3.4. First we will take out the start. After this we will enter the input. Number 1 is 1, starting and end 2. This is the last 5. It means if n1 is less than or equal to n2, it means that this is the equal of 5, and n1 is equal to 5 or less than 5, then we will divide. If n1 is mod 2 equals 0, if we will divide n1 to on 2, it will be 0. It should be display on screen output n1. And if set n1 to n1 plus 1, go to step 3. Step 3 mean that check that number is greater or less or equal. So now these are the 6 steps. So now now we will move to step 3. If n1 is less than and equal to n2, then we will check 2. What we will do? We will check that 2 is the less than 1 or not. First we will check the 2. If the remainder is 0, then of course it will be display output, and this will be 2 plus 1, it will be 4. Then we will check the 3 number, and after this if 3 is divided by 2, that will 0, then output will be n1, otherwise it will be move on next. So first you have to check that how much you have done steps. It means that on each digit you have done 4 steps, and we have performed 5 digits. N1 means starting 1 and N2, this that was ending point 5, and 1 to 5 it's mean 5 digits we have enter, and 5 multiply with 4, it will be 20, and that is 21, 22 and 23. And in algorithm 9 that we have done, that it take 23 steps and one step will be more. That were step 6. Why? Because in step 5, that if we take 5 and 1 plus that is 5 and plus 1, then will be answer will be check from the step 3, that is not equal to 5 and also not less than 5. So it's mean that total steps involved in algorithm 9, these are 24, and in algorithm 1 only take 10 steps. And now you have to say that algorithm 1 is too much efficient if we have to compare with algorithm 9, because we have done complete activity. And also you can say that algorithm 1 only take 10 steps for 5 digit, but algorithm 9 take 24 steps. So it's mean computer only computer memory also consume, and we will use only first algorithm because use less memory. Okay, now we have to move on activity 1.10. it's mean that activity 1.10 is that when you will enter in school, that system is there, that one computer is there and your picture is also present in that computer, and you will stand on front of that computer. If your picture will be match, then a computer marks yes, you are present. Otherwise if your face not match with that picture, that will display the message this student is absent. Now the question is that test the data that how can you improve the system. So first we will dress, we will manage dress. After this we also can use different haircut. Also we can identify the different cameras. So first now these are 3 suggestions for improving the system. The first is that student dress will be different in winter and summer. It's mean that in winter you use different jerseys and other things, but in summer you use only shirt. And if someone has injured his face, if there is any accident or any other issue with the student, what system will do? So it should be think about it. And next is, if a person plays picture of someone in front of the camera, it means if the any person will take your picture and put front of that computer camera that which is having your picture, so that is that will be take attendance or not, so it should be improved. Now I will discuss about the activity 1.11. So I have also discussed in lecture number 7 and lecture number 5 that test data. So this is the activity for you. You have to take the data and data from 1 to 7, and that should be display the invalid message if you will enter 8 or less than 1. So I was discuss this activity in previous lecture, that if student will enter 1, that will be display Monday. Similarly, if the system will display the 7, it mean that will display the output is Sunday. So similarly, you have to design a algorithm, and you have to discuss with your friends or class fellows that they you have to design for this purpose, that if the invalid data you will enter, what message will display on screen. And students, I hope that you have to understood complete chapter number first and also all activities of chapter number first. If there is any question, you can ask from me, but first you have to do practice, and this is a activity for your test. First you have to read it, and I have suggest few things here. You can read with careful. So after this, you have to do activity on this. So I hope that you have to better understand. If there is any question, here is my Gmail address, sirbaba19967@gmail.com. You can ask from me. Okay, students. Allah Hafiz.